What are those called again?
So what's up, guys? Welcome to the fucking gathering.
Right,
some first time gatherers are here.
First time ever.
So what led you to coming out this year? What was it about this year that made you want to come out?
Well, fucking hard life, and finally made it to a point that we could fucking do it. You know, this shit happened.
Everything
so
fell in place just right
years
for me to get these people
shit
together here.
Fucking downhill, and now it's coming up, man.
Where are you guys from?
I'm from West Virginia.
Yeah, he's West Virginia. He's from West Virginia.
And he's
living in Hickory. I live in Hickory, North Carolina. And it's fucking amazing how we made it all the way here to the gathering.
Yeah. How long of a trip was it for you guys?
Six and a half, seven, something like that.
It was 11 for me.
11.
Yeah, I split it up over 2 days. It wasn't that bad, though.
Yeah, it wasn't bad, man. Hell, it's all worth it, though, to come
for
here.
For real.
Yeah. Excited. Hell, it's such a short trip. 20 years for me.
Your first time, you said?
Because of him. He bought me a ticket.
Dude, that's what's up.
His family and fam, I had to drag him along.
Yep.
He made a detour to pick him up along the way.
That's what's up, man.
Where I'm at, I'm like the only Juggalo on site.
Dude, same with me. There's like no, I have like no Juggalo friends where I'm from. That's why I'm alone.
Oh, we're from West Virginia. It's in the middle of redneck, fucking nowhere. It's fucking, it's crazy.
It's like none's around, but they're all around. You
yeah.
know what I mean?
Yeah, that's true.
You don't know where they're at, but they're there. Because
motherfuckers
hiding out somewhere.
In Charleston, where I was at, there was a hatchet man, like, painted on the bridge. Never saw a Juggalo, though.
But they're around.
No doubt, they're everywhere.
I guess shit up. Fucking bomb time, man. Coming to the gathering the first
Finally.
Time.
Finally.
This shit's gonna be fucking live. We got the VIP to meet them, man.
Oh, that's what's up. When are you guys doing that?
Bucket list dream, man. I've always dreamt to fucking meet them.
11.
Anyway, that shit's gonna be so fucking bomb.
You guys got any special questions or anything you're gonna ask them?
No, I ain't
thought about it yet. The main thing is
just to fucking meet them, man. You know how much of an inspiration they've been to me is fucking amazing, man. I can sit here and run my mouth all day long, and I know there's hundreds of thousands and know what I'm talking about when you're that motherfucker who's all alone and don't know shit, but you listen to fucking ICP and they pull you through it some fucking how.
Oh, yeah.
They give you the what's the word I'm looking for here? The confidence to fucking know that you are the shit. You know, no matter what motherfuckers say, rich society, fuck this world, you know, the world system sucks. The world itself might be beautiful, but the fucking world system sucks. When you got motherfuckers like us, willing to pull together and do shit for each other no matter what, dude, that's what makes it worth fucking living.
And
coming to this shit.
I saw ICP in Michigan a long time ago, like in 2000. Went to Twisted, Beckley, West Virginia. They showed up in West Virginia, and we got to go. We went to that, and then he tied me up for this. It'll be my third one ever.
You gotta be excited,
I'm
man.
I'm fucking excited.
First time we met this kid.
It's the first time we met. Yeah.
Actually, our first concert was the Bizarre concert.
This has got to be so special to you guys, then. I mean, the Bizarre show, you guys got to be looking.
It's like, I just knew I was coming to Canada, and then I found out about it being the Bizarre, and was like, damn, that's some crazy shit, man.
This one's Inner
first
City.
First gathering, first concert.
Whatever. Inner City Posse?
Inner City Posse. Was it Bizarre Thursday, Inner City Posse Friday, and then a mix set. We don't even know what we're going
to
get for Saturday. Yeah, I'm hoping they don't got COVID or anything, because they canceled their whole tour. John Davis from Korn got COVID.
He did?
Yeah, Korn canceled one show so far, but it was like someone in their camp has it, then I guess someone leaked that it was John that has it, so
it's not...
I do.
Mankini got it, too.
Mankini got it?
Sorry.
No, you're good.
It's like,
my main thing is family, like we chant the family shit and all that. We help each other out. Don't matter if you're rich, poor, anything, what color you are. None of that shit matters. It's all about unity. It's all about family.
Absolutely.
That's what Juggalo is to me. And anybody claiming Juggalo, they can like a fucking ICP song, Twisted, whatever. That makes them Juggalo to me. If you're into it, you're into it. That's Juggalo. It's a way of life, man.
Yeah, straight up. It truly is. It's just what it is, you know. It's a person, if you hate, you hate, he's still gonna love you. He's still gonna be himself, you know, yeah, regardless of how anybody.
My main
feels
thing
about
with it,
it,
honestly, is the fact that, like, they don't care how fucked up you are or whatever, like, come on,
everybody's
in, you know?
Welcome, yeah.
You
know,
all the freaks are welcome.
Yeah, it don't matter. Anybody. We won't judge you.
Anybody, right.
They talk about, man. It's like, it don't matter who you are.
Boy,
you
be the ugliest, dumbest,
fucking some bitch on the earth. Man, you right here with me, dude. I ain't gonna say that I'm not the ugliest, dumbest, some bitch there is, you know? But fucking, they let me here, and I'm feeling the love already.
Around that, I get downed all the fucking time for it. I get shit all the time. I don't give a fuck. I'll always be down. I don't care. It's my family doing this shit. My blood. And I don't give a fuck. I'll keep doing it until dad dies.
Absolutely. Michael Patrick. I'm born on Halloween, man. It's born within me already, so. You know,
October 28th, so I relate. Not quite Halloween, but I'm in the vicinity.
Yeah, we all party together, man. You know, it's awesome. You know, it's just natural.
It was already there before. We're the ones that started the Juggalo shit, the fans.
We started
this shit.
You know, I've heard people being kind of scared, worried to come to places like this. I've never worried about it, you know, because I'm there. You know, I'm with them, and we know what it feels like to be fucking looked down on or whatever, and be scared of somebody to think something different about you. But you know, you gotta get past that.
Like a murder, there's never been a death in any of these gatherings. There's never been no like severe damages to anybody. Everybody's careful. Nobody's fighting. Yeah.
It's all love in my experience. You know what I mean?
How about freedom?
And if it's someone starting a problem, it's not a Juggalo.
Came about the woods and found myself a carnival. Freaks from each hood rep their set at the carnival. Fun in the sun, it's a party at the carnival. We can be as one, speaking for the carnival. Ain't got a ticket, so they're sneaking in the carnival. All the clowns are wicked, but they don't seem as comical. Think this is a gimmick, it's soaking in my follicles. You don't have to get it, ain't supposed to be logical. Soda pop, raindrops, magic made the pain stop. Cheap pop, double whoop drop, do it like a doobop. Jumping off the rooftop, should I say the big top? Straight chugging and it don't stop, saying this ain't hip-hop. Flipped off, you can get hip-tossed. No, sell your hits off, marks are getting ripped off. Only if you did wrong, if not, it's all good. We can all get along, it could be as it should. We don't have to be misunderstood. If they could, they can't understand that we're sorta good. We're kinda good, ain't all that bad. Celebrating, we're all weird. Ain't no going back, I'm just glad we made it here. Fresh out the forest and found myself a carnival. Built it just for us carnies working at the carnival. Underneath the moonlight shining at the carnival. You can hear the loons like Jake can hear the carnival. Came about the woods and found myself a carnival. Freaks from each hood rep their set at the carnival. Fun in the sun, it's a party at the carnival. We can be as one, speaking for the carnival. Hanging with the scrubs, always knew I was a floob. Home with my jugs, shout out to the brothers Brew. Joey too. About that real love, but they think of us as rude. If they came to hang with us, they would change their attitudes. There's rides, there's games, there's sights, there's stains. You can't erase from the inside of your brain. Some came from lives of pain, others hide their face behind the paint. Walk through the midway, realize I'm not a saint. This ain't for you if your heart is faint. Afraid where it's taking you, letting go of all restraint. Maybe you don't relate, eating from your golden plate. Easy for you to hate one in when they close the gates. You're gonna have to wait, marking out for the stars. Revealing all your fate since carnage dropping cards. Revel in their mysteries, it's all so magical. All these synchronicities, the carnival is supernatural.
Before I came out to the
list. Hold on.
Yeah, precious, brother. Don't lose this, baby.
No, I will not. Keep it on all fucking weekend.
There it is.
Maybe a little bit
enjoy
after.
Yourself.
Thank
be
you, man.
Safe.
Hey, are you letting people in? That
I don't have that intelligence. They do at the booth.
Okay, thanks, man.
Fresh out the forest and found myself a carnival. Built it just for us, carnies working at the carnival. Underneath the moonlight shining at the carnival. You can hear the loons like Jake and hear the carnival. Came up out the woods and found myself a carnival. Freaks from each hood rep their set at the carnival. Fun in the sun, it's a party at the carnival. We can be as one, speaking for the carnival.
So what's up, my guy?
What's going on, man? My name's Caleb. I'm the creator and owner of Puppets of Emotion, and I'm at the Gathering 2021 promoting my stuff, so...
That's what's up. You fuck with ICP and the Juggalo scene?
I grew up with them. I was introduced to them before I was even born.
Work.
So it's made a full circle. This is my first gathering, so it's kind
That's
of special.
That's what's up, man. Yeah. So, would you consider yourself a Juggalo, if you will, or are you just more of a fan of the scene?
I'm a very interested fan.
Yeah, I hear you.
I do like the communal vibe here, though. It's unlike anything else, I think.
You're going to slowly get drawn in, and then before you know it, you're going to be leaving with an ICP jersey and throwing Faygo bottles at people on the way. Your artist name, Puppets
of Emotion.
What would you say that represents or means, if you will?
For me?
Yeah, the meaning. Is there a deep philosophical meaning to the band
there
name?
There is for me.
One that you would like to share? Is it a private one?
It's not private. It's just celebrating anything and everything at the same time.
Words.
I look at it as the circle of life. And we are bound to it, whether you like it or not. And I always ask people what they exist for, or why they choose to continue living, because it is a choice.
Right.
So it's whether you feel positive or negative at any time, it's always 100% relevant. So it's always gonna have the fullest meaning in your life at every moment. So
right.
You always come back to feeling happy. So it's almost like, when I wrote, I was in a very negative mind space, so I was like, not in control, but I've gotten much better at maintaining myself. A little bit of everything and nothing in one, so.
Bring on the power to those who are powerless. Forever a beast. I stay on the move. My child is soulless. Nobody can stop me. That's why the me and these haters watch me. They don't want me obstacles. When nothing can fall, they never can block me. I break the glass. I break the next.
Smoke that weed if y'all got it. Just that one for it. We wind it down. Oh, pick it back up, let it go, man. Oh, the man I'm on. Fuck this world. We my call. Brains on the so cold. Put an angel, get a brace. Put a poor call. Which way to the point? Let's begin to meet to the grave. Go, Lord. time, huh? It's a fucking noise if you cry me in this bit. It's a motherfucking noise if you juggle on. It's a motherfucking noise. Don't go with me, mate. Don't go with me, mate.
Yeah, I make some noise for them.
I will fuck you. Fuck you, fuck you, I fuck you up. I'ma fuck this bitch up if he don't bring me my food. I mean it's already late, why ain't gotta be rude?
What?
I'ma fuck you.
Fuck you.
I'ma fuck you.
Fuck you, fuck you, I'ma fuck you up. Hey.
Reject shit.
Reject shit.
Reject shit.
So what up? We're here with Toxic Plague Entertainment crew.
What up?
Just pulled up, and of course I roll in and find these motherfuckers coming up. So what's up, guys?
Not much. We're just getting the fucking camp ready. We got here a little late last night.
What time did you guys get here? Because I left here at like 6 a.m.
Fucking 2 a.m. we got
here. Oh, damn. So you guys were rolling up when we were like fucking talking about where are they?
Oh, fucking yeah, straight up. And we just been trying to get the camp ready. We're about to be doing our 1700 subscriber giveaway in the next fucking hour or so.
That's fresh as fuck, man.
Giving back, I mean, we pretty much paid for like three people's tickets now.
Dude, that is so cool.
It's all fam love, dog, straight up.
That's so dope you guys are doing that. That really is fresh as fuck, man.
Just gotta get back, man. When this shit does so much for you and they don't even know about it, you gotta do something back.
Right.
Just make the shit known. Hell yeah.
Well, you guys are killing it with the YouTube shit, so congratulations.
Straight up, dog. That's
the growth is really impressive. You guys said you started in what, January?
We started the end of January.
That's amazing, because what, you're over 2,000 now, right?
We were at like 22 last night.
Amazing, dude.
I haven't checked it today. I normally check it every day.
Well, let's keep that shit growing for you guys. That's amazing.
Definitely. And, like, straight up, we're doing that fucking documentary shit. We want you to be a part of that.
Please, hit me up. Please, I'll be all over this motherfucker. Right. I ain't leaving.
So, if we run into you, we'll get a fucking quick interview. We want you.
You'll see me. You'll see me. I'll be chilling with Stoney and shit. You already know.
All right, brother. Much love. Thanks for fucking
I'll see you guys in there, man.
Much love,
peace out, man. Nice meeting you guys. Camera?
Sure.
You're all painted up. You might as well, right?
Might as well get it out here.
So what's up, my ninja? What's your name and where are you from?
I'm Joker.
Oh, wait, we talked yesterday. Yes. Holy shit, you have the makeup on now.
Yeah, I'm Joker from Birmingham, Alabama.
That's what's up. I talked to this fella yesterday. He didn't have his makeup on, and he was saying he didn't want to get filmed until he had his makeup on. So once again, how amazing is it that I just run right into him immediately when I get here?
It happened.
Magic. Gathering magic, my guy.
It is. It's ninja magic.
So how was your night last night?
It was good. That was up till like 5 a.m.
Same, pretty much.
Yes. Slept till like 9 this morning.
Yeah.
Takes me a little bit to get this on, but then once I get it on, it's on.
It's on.
It's on
indeed.
Just can't touch it.
You don't do the setting stuff or anything like that?
It's that way if I have to move it around, like if I do touch it, I can move it around sometimes.
Manipulate a little bit if you got to touch up.
It's a little thick over here. I may move it over here in this thin spot. But yeah, so.
Well, that's what's up, man. So, just my real quick general question I like to ask a lot of people is like, what does being a juggalo mean to you? Like in a deep philosophical way or even not deep philosophical way. Like you personally, like what does being a juggalo mean to you? You know what I mean?
I've been through some dark days a while back and this music saved me. It brought me from that. It gave me a not really a purpose, but gave me a feeling or a sense of family.
Right.
And then I was able to catch a couple of gatherings and I've been to, this is now number 7.
Video about me or with me, you can. Hey, I'm serious. I'm funny as shit, drunk or not. Woo woo, motherfucker, this is my first gathering. If you real, come on down. If you fake, get the fuck lost, bitch. You like Dark Lotus, then that means you like Twisted. If you don't like Twisted, then
you're
fucking liar. I love you. Whoa. Whoop, whoop. And I love you, Mr. Cameraman.
Me too.
Hey, look, I'm Steffi Mac on Facebook. I'm on Facebook. I don't really get on that. But it's Strangula on Instagram. It's at Strangula. I know I'm drunk, but if you get on my shit, you'll see that I ain't like this all the time. This is my first time at the gathering.
Welcome.
And thank you. And this is the first time that I feel open to be who the fuck I am.
That's awesome.
And if y'all don't motherfucking like it, get the fuck out, because I love everybody.
We love it. We like it that you are who you are here.
I had people in there judge me for wearing my twisted necklace. I got this tattoo over fucking like 10 years ago or some shit. Many, many years. It was in double digits of years that I got this tattoo, and it was fucking almost 20 years. It's so embarrassing. I'm drunk, clearly.
You're good. You're
but
good.
I feel safe to be drunk with my family. I feel safe to be like this with my family here, because with my real family, I can't be like this.
I relate.
I can't be like this. I can't be real like this. But only real motherfuckers who understand me, they feel where I'm coming from. And you know what? It's them same motherfuckers who keep coming back by to check on me, because they know I'm out here checking the loyalty stamp at this motherfucking drive-in.
She's on one. That's dope, though. I'm glad she's feeling like she can be herself. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's dope.
That is dope. That is awesome. Very, very awesome.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. I love you, too.
Like, I love you.
Welcome home.
Yes, thank you.
Definitely welcome home.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Because I didn't feel welcome when I first got here.
It's the twisted bullshit. Don't even play into it. Don't even play into it.
It's the twisted bullshit. It's the lack of loyalty that motherfuckers have for real family. Distant bloodlines or not. Guess what? A lot of us had divorced parents, okay? And like twisted and insane clown posse. It's like our parents that fucking divorced.
Yeah.
You still love your mommy and daddy, don't you? Yes, you do. I see you looking at me, Mr. Red, in the middle. And you over there in the hat, and you. Cheers, baby. I ain't out here making nothing but points. This is the worst gathering I ever been to. This is my first gathering.
Only day one.
No.
You were got here on day zero.
No, listen. Baby, twisting, blazing, ABK. Fucking young wicked man. I know what young wicked did. I don't know. But you know what? His daughter did. He's still the artist, and he still makes a lot of valid points in my life, and I love them just as much as I love them.
It's family. It's at least the old schoolers.
Yeah.
Some of the new schoolers, it's a little different for them. But for the ones of us back, you know, years ago, like when I first started coming, I've been to six. The last one was here in 2014. So I'm happy to be back here 2021, which is really awesome. 7 years later, kind of weird. This happens to be my seventh one.
And 7 years and seventh gathering. Yeah. Look at that.
Yeah.
Some little number synchronicities there.
Right? It's kind of scary. But it always works out that way.
Yeah. Weird coincidences.
You know, but God, it's you know, the music has pulled me through some dark times, and so it's kept me together. It's kept me sane ish. But I mean, you know, it's why I keep coming back. I've got friends. I actually am traveling around the country right now, and I've stayed with four of the friends that I've met in the gatherings in years past, and I've known them 13 less years, like 13 is the furthest back, you know, years forward, and they let me, a couple of them let me stay on their couch. We didn't know each other before. We hung out for the whole weekend, but
family, man.
Yeah,
family.
It is.
It really, that's, you know, that stuff like that makes you really realize it. It is like family, you know, more than just being friends or homies or whatever.
Yeah. Keeping contact with each other. Like, I've got one homie who lives up in Washington State. That's where I was going next. And he just texted me last night and said his cousin came to his house and had COVID and spread it through his whole household.
Ooh.
And now they're all positive tested. He's like, dude, we're going to be quarantined for 15 days. I'm just letting you know. I was like, okay, keep me heads up. Let me know how it's going, because I'm supposed to go from here to there. you know, a couple of stops in between, but more or less my goal was to get to Washington State. And now where I was going to go to Washington State is now infected.
Sheesh.
So it's like, great.
Yeah, so maybe not go there.
I may have to cut from Green Bay down to Sacramento, California, because that's the next, from Washington, that was where I was going to go. So I may end up changing, you know, my plans are loose. So they just, you know, I just got to be back in Birmingham by October. So, but yeah, but I mean, I'm staying with Juggalos. I'm staying with
some of
the coolest people. I mean, open their house up to me, feed me at night. I didn't even have to buy food. I just had lunch is all I had to deal with. And they would feed me their, like, they would make extra of their dinner or buy extra pizzas or, you know. This is one of those kind of like walk in nature or walk in your mind kind of thing. This is opening my world right here. Just like being able to go, hey, we met at the gathering like 12 years ago. Hey, can I crash on your couch? You know, send them a message on like Facebook Messenger and shit. And they're like, yeah, fuck yeah, ninja, come on.
Yeah. It's just so accepting, awesome. Man.
Yeah. Or, hey, I don't have any room in the house, but I got a yard, you can throw a tent. You got an air mattress? And I was like, yes. And so it's, you know, it's like that. It's crazy. But, I mean, it's, you know, it is what it is. And it is family. And it is love. I didn't pick a side. I'm with both. I just wish they would get their shit together and at least try to do some stuff here again together. If it was just Twisted rolls in, does their shit, leaves, or the whole night is Twisted, you know, like M&E for one night of the gathering. It's like, you know, you have ABK, Blaze, drive.
That would
by,
be a dope idea.
You know,
I mean,
and have one night.
There has to be some work done though,
yeah,
on both sides.
Oh,
the,
yeah.
They Twisted's got to admit they're wrong, and Jay's got to admit he's wrong on certain
certain
ways too, and that's the only way real growth is going to happen. Or,
and that's going to take some time.
Yeah, it's going to take years.
Yeah,
especially with this.
Look how long the M&M squabble went on for. I mean, that went on almost a decade and a half. So,
yeah,
I mean, it's going to be a long.
And it's
time.
Still questionable if M&M is carrying feelings or not about that shit. You really don't know. ICP seems to want to squash the beef, but really don't know how M&M feels about it.
Right.
I'm sure. It's only a matter of time until we get Eminem and ICP on a track, though. Only
right,
a matter of time.
I'm pretty sure. And the other thing about it is, though, is like he's already done a track. He did Worldwide Choppers 2 with Tech. With Tech and Chris. You know, so Strange has already accepted me.
Yeah.
You know. So I was hoping that maybe, you know, maybe he would be able to move from going from Strange to Psycho and do at least a song or, you know, something where even if they're like sitting there fucking busting on each other the whole song, but it's part, you know, that's like what those like big verses,
yeah,
or something like that,
make it creative,
yeah, and have the two of them.
That's not a bad idea, honestly.
Maybe have Dre drop in and do something like, you know, Shaggy starts to jump in on it and Dre comes in and, you know, they're at each other, you know, those two are at each other, you know, kind of thing, and then that way, you know, and just let it kind of have like a versus, you know,
right,
and just have it like that, you know, where they're both at each other, you know, and not them taking a song and flipping it and handing it back to him like, here you go, here's your shit plate, you know. Yeah. But yeah,
well, hell yeah, Joker, thank you so much for talking to me, man. I really appreciate it.
No problem at all.
Whoop whoop
whoop whoop.
Thank you. maybe later on tonight.
Whoop whoop, guys. Sorry, man. What up? Whoop whoop.
That's all we can do.
That's all we can, man. We're just so fucking. We're always trying to work.
What up? Oh, thank you. I'm all set for now. I appreciate it.
Hey, I got faces.
Holy shit. What the fuck? That is crazy. Josh, what up, man? Holy shit, nice to see you, bud. Here, bring it in. Bring it in for a hug, my guy. Good to see you, buddy.
I thought it was you.
So you made it. I'm glad you made it. When'd you get here?
Like 2:30 yesterday.
2:30 in the morning?
No, afternoon.
Oh, okay.
Now it's got an hour and a half drive from all that.
Oh, that's not that bad. That's not that bad at all. Hell yeah. Where are you camped at, my guy?
Up to the right.
Out there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Word up. I haven't even been over there. I don't know if I realized that there was camping over there.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Hmm. Okay, okay.
Yeah, because they just in like 9:30 last night.
Word. Oh, they were, yeah, that's right. I was out here last night and couldn't, you don't got a car pass. You just walked in?
Yeah, we just walked in.
Yeah, I was out here trying to get in forever, and I think it was damn near 11 o'clock by the time I realized they were finally letting in the Juggalos.
Yeah. Yeah, we came with somebody who had with a car pass, so we packed up, call up.
Oh, you did that game. I almost did that shit.
Yeah, we did that to beat some stuff up. So.
Yeah. Well, it's nice seeing you, man. I'm sure we're gonna be around. Oh, hey, look at this. Juggalo love.
Oh, he is my kid. So.
Yeah, Chuck Reeves made a joke about me saying I look like him with hair, and it just kind of stuck. Yeah. He became dad. we fucking pranked Father Tom Wood. We pranked Tom Wood with it. Confused the fuck out of him.
I even mentioned it when he was on the... Yeah, Mr. Lee was on the show.
Well, I'm gonna head down to that stage there because they got some shit popping off. I'm trying to catch a hex-rated set, but I'm sure I'm gonna see you around, my guy. Yeah. Thank you, Josh.
No
Harris here.
Yeah, I'm gonna flash the.
Oh fuck yeah,
the
bro.
Gang sign, the FBI.
The we're not a gang sign.
We're not a gang sign. Right? Yeah, it's we're not. We're
The loosely affiliated not a gang sign.
They don't understand what they don't understand the dark carnival and all that. So all right, let's see. Thank you. All right.
You got an accent, fellow. Where are you from?
I'm from Tennessee, but my family is from Scotland. Over
Scotland.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah,
I can definitely hear it.
We're pure blood Tennessee. Yeah. All right.
That's what's up, man.
Yeah, we're straight from the hills. Yeah, we're like them crazy. Yeah, we're like them rebels. We're like the Taliban of America, basically. We've got like an honor-based society. Yeah, you come in. If you come in and respect us, yeah, we'll respect you back. If you disrespect us, I wouldn't recommend coming to Tennessee. I mean, people say we're nice, but yeah, we're nice. If you're nice back, yes, sir. And I appreciate the invitation to the gathering of the Juggalos.
Hell yeah, man.
Hell yeah.
Is this your first year?
Yes, sir.
Welcome home, man. Welcome
home. Thank you. Is this your first year?
Second year.
All right. No, I'm a fan. Are you a fan of that Ouija Macc?
Big fan. Big fan.
All right. You come here for him, or?
ICP, Ouija, Danny Brown, NASCAR Aloe. Those are the ones I'm really looking forward to seeing this year.
All right.
Yeah.
Ouija Macc, something down.
Danny Brown. Check Danny Brown. He's Saturday night before ICP. He's going to be the shit.
All right. And this is the main one?
The main stage is right down there. And then those secondary stages, right there and right there.
All right.
Over there.
All right.
Yeah, be careful your wares, my guy.
All right. Where are you from?
Vermont.
Vermont. All right. North Vermont, South Vermont?
Southern Vermont. Southern Vermont. Yeah.
All right.
Pretty much right on the border of New Hampshire. Actually, I literally live on the border of New Hampshire. Right on the river.
All right.
So, yeah.
All right. Normally wear this like this, or this is
no, it's a sweat. It's trying to get the sweat out of my face, and it's not working that well.
the green hair.
Oh yeah, green. It's freshly dyed. I was actually purple before. This is an interesting to record. Let me. What up, guys?
We found some more Juggalos.
I just keep running into people, I swear to God.
Yeah, same. We just barely walked in and everyone's like, hey!
It's the weird thing about this place, I swear. It's just coincidence after coincidence, and it's strange.
Yeah.
It's really strange. It starts to add up so much that it's hard to ignore. So how you guys doing?
Wonderful.
How was last night?
Sleepy.
Yes.
We fucking fell asleep at like midnight. Slept all day.
Sleepy
had to get
indeed.
Nice and rested up for today.
Yeah.
You know.
Good plan. Good plan.
We're old, so.
Yep. We're on our mission to the merch booth.
Oh,
are
yeah.
You doing this for your podcast, dude?
Yeah, this is going to be for the YouTube gimmick. For the YouTube gimmick. Going to try to do a little movie again, you know? Trying to put together clips of the jugs and all that.
Yeah.
Trying to do the walk down the hill, and I'm going to go walk through the merch booth and see if I can find homies
next
and shit.
Next couple months, I'm going to be doing a podcast. I'm going to start a podcast, so I want you to come
please,
on.
Please,
right?
Please.
Definitely.
Well, you guys, have a good one.
I'm just saying, Max CD
could be $100. A pre-roll,
a piece of shit.
People are donating shit to put under there.
It's a mystery bag.
Complete mystery.
You see the goat right there.
It's like, I don't even remember what I put under there.
Oh man, yeah, there is a little hint of gold.
Oh! Right, it looks like a Henny bottle. Oh, I don't know though.
We didn't do it. We didn't do it.
It's a mystery prize.
I don't know what it is.
Their ticket
should be rewarded.
Mystery prize!
Oh! They donated to the mystery prize.
Last time it was a Ouija Mac CD. That's why I've been standing here.
Well, anybody could get it.
Don't step on my baby.
Don't step on it.
It might be alive.
It's a mystery.
Well, anybody pick the mystery prize.
This is your first gathering, Eddie. Yeah. Could be $100. Could be a pre-roll.
It could be a jizz ring.
Or that
fire. No. Could be a jizz ring.
Absolutely.
It could totally be. Hell yeah.
100 right. bucks.
That's a risk. You gotta roll the dice in your life.
You gotta roll the dice.
You gotta roll the dice.
You get $100.
Mystery door one.
Boom.
Or mystery prize two. What's mystery prize two?
The only downside is if there is
mystery prize two kind of tends to be one
shit.
Yeah. Fuck yes. Yes.
If it,
do it. Do it.
Shit.
Do it. Do it.
Do it.
Let's see what
it is.
Well, what is it?
It's soap.
Oh, there you go.
But it's handmade,
so you gotta read the message.
Read the message.
But you gotta leave the envelope in this.
So you can scrub your ass.
Siren's call.
There you go. Show the camera.
And there was a trick. There's a trick in it.
Yeah,
there's a
port up your ass. You get a fucking, look at that chunky outline. Fucking. Don't eat it now. It's not eatable.
We're gonna be the fucking fortune cookie getting over here.
It's fresh as fuck.
This guy got on his hands and knees and was like all like looking like with his hair flying and picked it up all sexual. We was like, with his mouth, bro. And we was like, oh god.
What was under that one?
Ouija Mac CD.
Oh, that's the CD.
Come to the merch area! Come suck, Shank, fuck you!
How long are you guys? What did you tell me?
Whoop whoop. Holy shit. It's Devereaux and Darby.
What up?
What's up, guys?
How's it going, bro?
How's it going?
How was your trip up?
Great. A little bit long, yeah. But not too bad. So you guys running the merch booth, huh?
Yeah,
hell
right.
Yeah.
Got fucking ski masks.
Look at the wares.
Reversible bucket hats. You see what I'm saying?
Dude, that shit is fresh. The reversible merch, boys, you know, are dope. Saying? Dude, that is a dope fucking. Holy shit. Damn, he went crazy. I walked by a couple of times last night, but I did not really look. Oh, you're the man.
Thank you, sir.
Man, those Sox boys are fucking dope too. Holy
15
shit.
15 a piece, homie. One of a kind shit.
My God.
This hat, you get different patches. Slap the patch on it, you can take it off and put a different patch on it. He's got what, 12 different patches?
12 different patches. That is fresh.
How much are the buckets? Yeah. 40.
All right, boys. I'm sure I'll see you around.
See you, brother. Be safe.
Yeah, you too, man. Whoop, whoop.
Whoop, whoop.
I'll keep that in mind, my guy.
does being a Juggalo mean to you, my guy?
I think it's a lot about acceptance, even like whether or not somebody who already has a lot of acceptance or somebody who didn't get a lot of love, and being able to find people who you're kind of like, even if it's a very niche subgroup, you know? I feel like Juggalo encases a bunch of little different other families of things too. It branches out. Yeah. That's about all I got. All
right, man. Whoop, whoop. Whoop, whoop. Hell have yeah. A good one, my guy.
All right, have a nice one, man.
Man, I'm getting old, so to me this shit is boring. Let's drink some fucking Kool-Aid and die with our homies. No 40s or tears pouring at the funeral. Just burn my fucking body, snort the ashes up with the blow. Death is beautiful, it's just a part of life. So pour up, motherfuckers, we gon' die tonight. With a double
I need alcohol in this bitch.
Bitch, I'm Jim Jones! Jim Jones with a double cup! I'm Jim Jones! Jim Jones with a double cup! You better guzzle up! You better guzzle up! Jim Jones with a double cup! With a double cup!
All right, we got the homie Cringe here. What is up, my guy? With the goddamn Humble Among tattoo. Show off that boy real quick for me.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, Humble Among tattoo on himself. First one with the Humble Among. First one with the Humble Among tattoo, nonetheless, though. He got the alien head before I could get the alien head. Can you believe it? So what's up, man? This is your first gathering.
Yes, brought the whole family.
Got the whole fam. Hey, kiddos. How are you guys liking the gathering so far? You're looking at dad. It's okay. So, how are you liking it so far, man?
Love it. It's a great vibe. Chill. First time I've been out of the house, and I can't even for a minute. Crowds are a trip, but it's definitely a good vibe.
So, the standard question I've been asking a lot of people is, what does being a Juggalo mean to you? You personally, though, like in your head, what being a Juggalo for you, what does it mean? You know what I mean? You can get deep with it. You can get shallow with it. It doesn't really matter.
I don't know. Yeah, fuck people that hate you because you're different. Like that's, I love printing shit on me, and certain people just stay away from me, and I'm like, sweet. No, who not to hang out with? And like, but also donating and just shit like that. Like anything having a cause, and definitely liking music. Fucking love music. So anything to, if you can relate to it, get a feeling and, I don't know, get lost in it. that's a big part of it, I guess, because most people that I meet, the Juggalos are just into ICP, they're fucking Philly. But yeah, that's what a lot of things to me. I don't know. Sorry, I get nervous on.
Oh, you're good, bro. You're good. Thank you, man. Hey. God, that's gonna be amazing.
Beautiful.
That is gonna be amazing. That is a
right
fucking
now.
Awesome set.
Yes.
Oh, I can't wait.
I know. I don't even know what
oh,
that
this
means.
Boy was like, geez, 150, I want to say. Yeah.
That's not bad.
You can get them for cheaper though. You can get like $50 boys.
Oh, hey, keep it down. We're filming.
I don't have to sign a release for this.
That's really cool.
You want to help me film some content?
You don't have to sign a release, but do you want to be on the video?
Ooh.
All right, that's good enough for me.
Lunchbox, baby.
I signed.
Is this who's this
Ocean
going
City
to?
Ocean City Posse.
Thank you.
Ocean City, Maryland. Ocean City Posse.
Mike is for PA.
Oh, nice. I just say in York, so that's cool.
No shit. All right.
All right, we're here with Sean motherfucking Barrett. I'm so happy to see you here, man. So you make really cool fucking content. I'm a huge fan. But I've always wanted to ask you, what's your relationship with the Juggalo culture? Because there's an obvious relationship there.
Yeah, it's mainly through this guy, Clownvis. This is our third gathering now. The first time coming in, like, we were just welcomed right away. So just kind of trying to spread that love a lot through, like, the videos I do now. Always trying to represent that culture in, like, a really positive, kind of different, fun way. And then, you know, making friends with, like, Ouija Macc, and now doing videos with Shaggy and Keegan and Ouija and all those guys. It's been so fun.
Dude, it's awesome. I love what you're doing, man.
Thank you.
Everything,
thank you.
The stuff with Homeboy from Trap.
Oh, God. Yeah, I had to block him. Yeah, you blocked him? I had to, yeah. He can't take a joke, and he was just getting real serious and, like, wanted to fight. And he was just making up lies about me. And it was just, like, it was funny for a while, but then, like, it was just kind of sad. It felt like I was just punching down at this little guy. Because he makes some green screen videos, too. They're kind of, like, broke-ass versions of mine. He shoots them wrong. So he shoots them, like, down, so he looks like he's, like, 3 feet tall. Watch out. Watch behind you. It's been a fun...
You're good, bro.
It's been a fun little year making a lot of stuff, yeah.
Well, I love your content. Keep doing everything you're doing. You're killing it, man. I love your shit.
Thank you.
I hope you have a great fucking gathering. Clownvis at the Gathering of the Juggalos.
What's up, gang?
What's up, man? So you are hosting a lot of shit. You got a lot of responsibilities this year.
Yeah.
How do you feel being, like, tapped more to be in the Juggalo world? Like, because they've been using you a lot lately.
A lot, yeah. It's the best thing that's ever happened to me. I absolutely love it. From the first time I did the Gathering, this is my third time, but when I went into it first, I didn't know anything about Juggalo culture. I knew Insane Clown Posse, of course, but I was doing comedy clubs, and I was doing a touring with some rock bands, and it was just different. And when I first got to that Gathering, I knew right away it was fucking, it was home sweet home, and it's been perfect. And I've always wanted to do shit they have me doing now, you know, hosting game shows and doing little, I don't need to do my full set every time, you know, like, I'm better spread out, you know, freestyle a little bit, and they straight up have me game show hosting. It's a dream come true, you know, it's a job that I love to at least learn to do, and I feel like it's a good fit, so I'm going to do as much as they want.
Well, I'm a huge fan, and I think you're a great part of the Juggalo culture, a great new addition to this new era of the Juggalo culture, if you will.
I'm so proud of that.
And I support you so much, man. I'm a huge fan. I was actually, I filmed your 2019 set, a bunch of it, and your chicken hunting video that's on YouTube. That's my video.
Nice, man.
So a lot of motherfuckers love that video.
I got a good response.
And that was a great set. I need to give you props for that set. Because your lights kept going out.
And my laptop died right before we started.
Dude, but the way you rolled with it, those fuck-ups, and you almost made it part of the show, and honestly...
I tried to.
The way you twisted it, you kind of made it to me as, like, a comedy fan. You kind of almost made it like an Andy Kaufman thing where I couldn't tell if you were fucking staging it or not. Yeah, I'll be honest with you. So
I had to lean into... what was happening a little bit, but it was actually happening. I know exactly what you mean, because that's how I felt. I'm like, I'll just lean into it, but shit is actually falling apart, but if you make it part of the show, it worked. And, like I'm saying, the best audience in the world. They weren't going to let me die because the tech was dying on me, you know? Like, I think people watching could probably tell that, if anything, would feel sorry for me for a minute, you know, because lights and sound going to shit, and... you know, that was my sophomore return. I wanted to kind of, you know, pick it up from the year before, and fate wasn't letting me do that. But
you still did it. No, fate. I think fate was on your side in a weird way. It might have seemed like a bone at the time.
Yeah.
I think you killed that shit. Thanks. Straight up. I think it was just the fact that you're on your toes. That, like, it really shows how good of an entertainer you are, man. You're amazing.
Well, I appreciate that, man, and I truly feel, especially with this experience, that I'm trained for anything. I mean, I've just done shitty gigs for 100 years, you know what I mean? So when it works, it's also worth it, man. I love it.
Well, thank you so much, Clownvis. I hope you have a great fucking gathering.
Hell,
man.
Yeah, you too, man.
Thank you for talking to me. Whoop, whoop.
Whoop, whoop.
Now we're having some fun. It's a lovely game. Yeah, baby. All right. Now go ahead and bring the music down a little bit. I want to meet these nice ladies. Hello, how you doing? I'm gonna start down here at this end. My name is Clownvis. Talking to this mic here. See if this is on. You can pick it up if you want. See if that's on. There you go. She's got the skills.
You gotta hold that. She's got a death grip on this thing, ladies and gentlemen. It's about to blow. Here we go. Hey, hey. All right, there we go. Thank you. What is your name, sweetheart?
Erica, you can call me Pinky.
What does that say one more time?
Erica, you can call me Pinky.
Pinky, ladies and gentlemen. All right, Pinky. Pinky, are you in this to find true love, or are you in this to get backstage and hopefully fuck Vanilla Ice?
That's a hard question.
All right, all right. Well, Pinky, nice to meet you. What's your name, sweetheart? Pass the mic down to her.
I'm G, Miss G, Camp G Spot, yeah.
Miss G. Well, thank you for, what made you want to get up here? Are you excited or?
Because I
want
to play. What the fuck? The flames.
You made it this far, you want to get the fuck into the mix.
Yeah.
I get it. I get it.
Yeah.
I get it. Well, it's nice to meet you.
I get it.
It's nice to meet you. All right, let's see if your mic is on. If not, we'll just share this one here. What's up? Let's just share. Let's just share. Oh, there we go.
Hi, Rose.
This is Rose, ladies and gentlemen. Give a round of applause for Rose. Absolutely beautiful. And Rose, are you excited? Are you here to find love?
So excited.
You seem like a sweetheart. We got a sweetheart on our hands. All right, and your name is?
My name is Scribbles.
Scribbles! Beautiful name. Beautiful girl. Scribbles, what are you most excited about this particular thing we're doing
here?
Whoa, whoa. Thank you, Scribbles. And finally, what is your name, sweetheart?
I go by Cherry Pie 1986 on YouTube.
Cherry Pie.
But everybody can call me Cat.
Call you what? Cat. All right, got it. Got it. I was going to go with Cherry Pie. That's a good name.
Cherry Pie.
I haven't eaten and I'm hungry. Ladies and gentlemen, these are your contestants. Give them a round of applause. They're very brave. They're very fun-loving people. That's what we look for. That's what we look for. All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, you no peeking over here, gals. I'm going to bring up to the stage the male suitor. This is a guy who I've had the personal pleasure of watching perform. He's a fantastic artist. We're not going to use his real name. We're not using your real name because I don't want them freaking out. You know what I'm saying? Do you have a fake name I could use? What do you want to be called? Make something, make it.
Porkchop.
Porkchop. Great name. You have the chance to win a date with Porkchop. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to bring him up here. You get a good look at this son of a bitch because he's handsome. Bring him up, Porkchop. Good looking guy. This is how it's gonna go down, ladies and gentlemen. Porkchop is gonna ask a series of questions, and this is what we're gonna do right now. You are contestant one. You are contestant two. You are contestant three. You are contestant four. You are contestant five. Got it? So he will be asking you each individual questions. And answer to the best of your ability. You know, maybe lay it on thick. Maybe try to win this fucking thing, huh? All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna turn it over to Porkchop, our male suitor. Okay.
How's everybody doing today? Okay. So, Juggalette number one. I love a Juggalette who's wild. Tell me about a time you broke the law or got into a fight.
There's a filing system here, and are you talking about within the day, within the week, within the year, or lifetime? Well, here's the deal. I broke the law coming here. The car was overweight, 10 cases of water from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. In a fucking torrential downpour. And I flew through that shit like a bat out of hell. In a 92 Honda Civic. Get shit.
Okay.
You so know you want me, baby.
We yeah, fought against danger to get to the gathering.
Brave.
I can respect that. Who can respect that she went through danger to get to the gathering? I love a Juggalette who's wild. Tell me about a time you broke the law or got into a fight.
Well, about 3 weeks ago,
ago, I did a whole bunch of shrooms and went down.
That's illegal!
I'm Portland.
That was the question. She broke the law. I'm not a cop.
Was that the end of that story?
Yes, that's the end of the story.
Okay, that's fair. That was illegal. That's the real answer. Juggalette number four. Same question. Same question for you.
Well, I look suspicious as fuck, so I get pulled over not doing shit. And I usually have all kinds of shit on me, but I'm a fucking ninja and I'm a gangster. I'm hiding in my titties so they don't catch me doing shit.
Alright, bet with a crown like that.
Hey.
That was pretty cool with that.
Okay. Juggalette number two. What is your most absurd turn on and why?
So I really like a guy that has really intense back muscles, and I really like to sniff armpits. I don't know what it is, but it's really good.
She is in paradise right now. Hold your armpits. Everybody hold your armpits up for this lady right here. Give me Are you walking off? Are you quitting? Oh, no, good. This is getting a drink.
Okay. Juggalette number five. Same question. What's your most absurd turn on and why?
Well, I work at a sex shop, so anything's game for me.
That's a lot of answer.
Okay, and now Juggalette number one. Same question. What is your most absurd turn-on, and why?
Well, you know, I like to cover myself in my paint, lay in my room, underneath the lights of the LEDs, and whisper to myself, you really do matter, and don't swim with that toaster in your bathtub.
You gotta love honesty. You gotta love the honesty.
Respect, yeah.
Okay, question number three. Juggalette number four. If you could, would you be on Elon Musk's first rocket ship to colonize Mars? Why or why not?
I don't know. I'm about that alien shit, but I kind of like it here. There's better weed here. How is Mars weed? I'm not sure how much I like that shit.
Mars weed!
I'm
going to
stay here. It might be out of this world. She's right. Soak it. I'm going to Mars, bitch.
It was initially a no, but at the
and
end,
then I changed my mind.
It was a yes.
I'm going. Who's going with me, fam?
Me and Melody.
Let's
ride.
Juggalette number two, are you going to Mars?
Absolutely. I'm fair a galactic enough alien goddess, so you best believe I'm gonna be on that bitch.
Ow.
Okay. What about Juggalette number five? You getting on that ship or what?
I want all them tentacles, baby.
She's fucking aliens.
Some hentai shit right there. Cool. Yeah. It. Juggalette number one. If your life was a reality TV show, tell me what a typical episode would be like.
Well, that's gonna have to be
Criminal Minds? That sounds dangerous for me, if we're being honest here.
Well, do you like danger, or do you like to be a pussy?
Oh.
Yeah, she went there. I mean, you could have gone to Astronomicon, but you know.
You could have.
You fucking could have.
Wow, the walls are coming off.
You want to date with me?
She's angry, actually.
I got weed.
Man.
I got weed. Let's just go. 35 years old, I got weed. Let's just go. Let's go.
Okay.
Sorry, Jared.
Juggalette number three. If your life was like a reality TV show, tell me what a typical episode would be like.
Well, I guess a typical episode would be wake up, smoke pot, get laid, go to work, get off work, get laid, smoke more pot, get laid, and then go to bed.
Sounds legit. I don't think she was lying. You think she was lying? Sounded like the truth. Sounded like the truth. Juggalo number four. Same question. If your life was a reality TV show, tell me about the typical episode.
I'd wake up, smoke some weed, grow some weed, smoke some weed while I'm growing some weed, come back home, smoke some more weed while I go buy some weed, maybe. And she said something about dildos. I'm all about that life. Typical day. I don't know. Is that allowed on TV? Maybe on Netflix. I'll be on Netflix, bro. Catch me on Netflix. Hallmark channel.
Damn,
after Christmas.
Oh shit, that is right, lady, settle down. The man's looking for love, not a conversation.
Oh, sorry. I ain't just looking kidding. For love, so I'm
looking
out of here, bro.
No, go ahead, ask your question again, Pork Chop. Alrighty, Juggalette. Number three, what's one of your favorite go-to moves during sex? It always seems to arouse your partner.
Bondage.
Handcuffs.
And hip clamps.
Oh, yes.
Alright, okay. Juggalette number five. Same question. What is your favorite go-to move during sex that always arouses your partner?
Hey, people go for them Paul Ross and popsicles. Man, when we get a freaky way down south, baby. Hold on.
And it's in my name.
Good answer. Pop Rocks and popsicles, is that right?
Let me
show. All right, yeah. One more here. All right, gentlemen. Number two, same question. Tell me about what sex move you like to do that arouses your partner.
Okay, so I'm gonna put you in a spreader bar, and I have this thing called the Volt 12. It has an electrostimulation cream, and then I'm gonna put it on your teeth so you can't stop coming, and then you will not be able to close your legs, so I'm gonna drain you from start to finish.
Yeah, just go. Come on, come on. It's not the view. I'm trying to keep this civil. Order in this court. You got some more questions for Trump?
I do. I got a few more questions.
Okay. Question number seven for Juggalette number five. What is one of your biggest oh shit moments in life?
I don't know. The time I was in prison or, let's see, hold on. What time? There's a lot of them.
Okay.
Let's see, hold on. Time I ran from the police for about 5 hours, and then they caught me at the quickie stop. I had to eat a Slurpee, what the fuck? That bitch got a drink.
She got a dreamer on
her. She has in that
hospital. Juggalo number three. What about your biggest oh shit moment?
That would be running from the cops and hiding in a riverbank while a helicopter flew over, praying to God they would not find us.
Alright.
That was a criminal. They did not find us.
Sounds like she's telling the truth. I'm gonna catch a rat by the end of the night.
Damn.
Juggalette number two, what about your oh shit moment?
So I am a manager at Adam and Eve, and I have to deal with a lot of really creepy individuals. Love stuff. So I had this guy come in, he was looking at the glass dildos, and I asked him if he needed some help, and he said no. About 5 minutes later, he walked out and said, have a great day. I went over and the glass dildo was gone.
2 minutes later, the power went out just in our store, but not in the building. I was like, oh shit, this is how people die in scary movies. So let me go lock the door, because the security card or the security cameras aren't on, so I gotta lock up. About 5 minutes later, this guy comes up and he's trying to get inside of the door. He's like jiggling this key, trying to get into the latch to open. And I'm like hiding behind the counter. I'm like going through some books, looking for this phone number to call to see if I can get the power back on. He comes around, which is where the office is. So I go in there and he's on speakerphone with this guy talking about, there's nobody here. I just tried to open the door. And the guy on the other line is like, I was literally just in there. There's only one girl. He's like, if I have to come back, he's like, I will use this glass dildo and I will break that bitch down. So I said, oh shit. What am I gonna do?
Oh, that's right. It was the oh shit moment. This was the oh shit moment.
Yes.
Honestly, I forgot the question, but that is a good story.
Luckily, we didn't get wrong.
She killed the man with a glass dildo, is what I gathered. Wow. All right. More questions.
Juggalette number four. What is something that people compliment you on often, and why do you think they do?
My fine ass. Like all them tattoos, all my freshness, my dope little drip drip. I've been killing it, dude.
Good answer.
Okay. Juggalette number one, what do people compliment you on and why?
Well, you know, it's usually my eyes, but you know, lately aww, it's just been my my tight end and my ability to not procreate anymore. I'm trying to win this bitch.
Juggalette number two, same question. What do people compliment you on?
Absolutely, hands down, my energy all the time. I got a real good energy. I've had like 1,000 hugs since I've been here. Everybody just coming up, I love you, man. I never met you before, but I fucking love you too.
Whoa, whoa, beautiful. Couple more questions, ladies and gentlemen.
Question number nine for Juggalette number three. What is something you typically think about while masturbating? And why do you think that turns you on?
Clownvis.
Nuggets.
Anal.
She say pee? Damn, she likes that R. Kelly shit.
Juggalette number one, same question. What do you think about while masturbating? And why?
Well, it's usually nugget porn, but it's whatever pops up on XNXX. We just run with it. It's a hard fact, but you know, we get through.
Juggalette number four, same question.
Oh boy, my search history is off the chain, dude. I just like that freaky shit. I don't know what to tell you. I like a little bit of everything.
Nothing wrong with that.
Is this the final question?
The final question, ladies, make it a good answer. This is the one he's going to remember. And then, ladies and gentlemen, he's going to pick one of these lucky winners, and we'll tell you more about what they get in just a moment.
Juggalette number two, are you crazy? And explain.
I'm absolutely the best type of crazy there could ever be. I will take you all over the galaxy without leaving Earth, and then we're going to have the best time. I'm talking about, I will put you in my traveling tattoo and Reiki studio, and I will dip down into your cerebellum, and I will create you the best custom tattoo design that nobody else will ever have.
Alright, she's selling it with that, man.
What about Juggalette number three? Are you crazy?
I'm low-key crazy. I'm not all out, no case of wild, but I like to do stupid shit and watch people do stupid shit. And I'm a little crazy every now and again. Maybe throw some fireworks or...
Hey, those are not
danger. Just saying danger. All right, I think he's got one more.
Juggalette number five. Are you crazy? And explain.
Well, let's see. I'm certified. I got it on me in three different ways. So if you don't know I'm crazy, I got it in Spanish, numerical, alphabetical. I mean, come on. I like midget porn and clown noses. I'm crazy as it is, baby.
Hell yeah. All right, Pork Chop. I hope you've been listening closely.
because it could be life or death. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Porkchop to think about what he's going to do while... What do you think? I want to give you a minute. You got an idea, right?
I'm getting ideas.
All right. Between contestant 1 through 5, Porkchop, tell us who it's going to be.
Number 4.
Any suggestions you want to help him out? What do you think? What do you think?
Number 4.
So close.
Number 4.
He's going to win number 4. All right, well, wait a minute. Let's meet who you didn't pick first, all right? Contestant number 5, come on down. This is contestant number 5. What was your name, buddy? This is Pinky. Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause to Pinky. Pinky. All right, contestant number 3, what was your name? This is Rose. Give Rose a round of applause. Good job, boys. Thank you very much. All right, contestant number 2, Scribbles, I remember. Congratulations. And contestant number 1, Cherry Pie, did not get picked. Go ahead and say hello. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me reveal the true identity of Porkchop. You know this motherfucker. You've seen him here around the gathering before. I watched him doing the cypher last time we did this, and it was fucking awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, Sewerside, meet your new lovely bride. These two lovebirds have won backstage passes from 8 to midnight on the main stage, watching Vanilla Ice, watching King Play, watching DJ Paul, watching ICP. Hopefully they give you some snacks and some water. Give them a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. All right, this is the second half of the game right now, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm gonna need some dudes.
It's an honor for me to be here at the gathering. Not only will I light myself on fire, not only will I bleed all over myself, but I will be introducing every fucking act that comes to the stage tonight. So, the very first act, of the gathering this year, the first main stage act post-COVID is ready to come to the stage. But before they come to the stage, I want to share something cool with you. I heard Show Your Butthole, and I'm telling you. My butthole is front and center in the new Jackass movie. It takes up the whole screen. You're gonna love it. But before I bring up this first act, I want to introduce someone super cool. This is a special person in my life. I call her a person, but she's a dog. I found her in the streets of Peru. And ladies and gentlemen, I want you to meet Wendy. Go ahead, girl!
Go on. Come on. So, this is Wendy. And we're here, we're gonna party with you guys all night. But, before we do anything else, let's get this fucking gathering started. Coming to the stage right now, the first act of the gathering 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go fucking crazy for 9 Dead.
Watch out.
Oh, yeah. Let's get some energy in that piece. More care. It's so easy, y'all can see all of this shit.
Okay. Everybody in the crowd's like a fountain. Hold on, I'm a bang, singing out of like a fountain.
So we're gonna have my freaky little friend help me out, give me some support because I'm a terrible performer.
Yo, my name is Andy Schultz and I'm from Los Angeles. And this is fucking crazy. Shows this is Miyagi Ness NASCAR. Hello, death proof.
There you go.
Hey. All I gotta say is thank you for accepting me into your family. And you best believe I'm gonna come here whether I'm in the crowd or whether I'm on stage. I'm gonna come here next year, baby.
Whoa, whoa.
I'm gonna wash my forehead off.
out, ladies and gentlemen. How are you guys feeling?
Whoop, whoop. Whoop, whoop.
All right, now, we got a few minutes before the next act, and I decided to do something special for you guys. I want to teach you how to get free alcohol for the rest of your life. Do you guys like alcohol?
Wait a second. Do you guys like to get fucked up? All right, I'm going to teach you a cool bar trick where you can get free booze for the rest of your life. This is very serious.
Now,
okay, when you walk into the bar, you go up to the bartender, you say, hey man, can I just get any kind of cup? Okay, you go to the bartender, you say, give me any kind of cup with any kind of liquid in it, right? You don't need any money, they'll give that to you for free. So here I've got this paper cup, and I'm gonna pour this water into it, okay? Now, here I have a cup of water. I wanna get a free drink, so I go up to somebody in the bar, preferably a dude on a date, okay? You go up to him and you say, hey guys, I'm sorry to bother you, but I'm about to blow you away with the most amazing bar trick you've ever seen. And you explain it. You say, I'm gonna put this drink on my head. As soon as I let go of this drink, okay, I'm going to balance it on my head. While it's balancing on my head, I'm gonna put my arms down by my side. What I have to do is, without raising my arms whatsoever, I have to drink that drink without spilling a single drop. Now you ask, if I can do that, would that be worth a free drink? The answer is yes. But if this fucking asshole says no, you go to the next person. You do not ever actually perform the trick until you have a commitment for a free drink. And that is why it works every single time. Now, are we clear on the rules?
Hell yeah!
Are you ready to see this awesome trick?
Fuck yeah!
Okay, here goes. Oh, DJ, let me get a tune for this.
Yeah!
Juggalos are in silence, shock and awe. What will happen next?
He kicks it.
It's not an easy trick, but it will get you free drinks every time. Now, if we're ready for the next act, are we ready for the next act, or should I do one more trick? Okay, I'm gonna do one more trick, but This one's not very easy at all.
Really love. If you guys got any kids in the crowd, now is a good time to cover their eyes.
Oh no.
Okay, now, this trick that I'm gonna perform for you right now is called the double back. It's called the double back because both my dick and my balls will be in the back. So here we go.
Myself. Are you down with the clown? That's officially my answer to every question that anybody asks me. Ask me a question. Yeah, I'm down with the clown. That's my answer. Not only am I down with the clown, but I'm ready to put on my makeup. I'm down with the clown, and I'm ready to put on my makeup. What I have here, ladies and gentlemen, is a light bulb. And I'm gonna break it on my head. So anybody's coming to the stage, please don't come barefoot. Shit. All right, I have broken glass all over the stage now. Sorry about that. I'm gonna pick myself a nice, fucking, nasty piece.
Good, right?
backup looks all right. You guys ready to keep this party going? Yeah! That didn't sound like shit. Are you guys ready to keep this party going? Because I will have you know there is only one more act before ICP. Are you ready? Whoop, whoop. Then make some fucking noise for Vanilla Ice!
Before computers ruined the fucking world. Let's do this. Yeah, baby, kick it one time. Like a motherfucker, we didn't write anything down. That's right, we didn't have no 1080p, we didn't have no snap crap, we didn't have no Twitter, no Instagram. Make some noise if you had a MySpace account. Damn,
set deck. Make some noise if you got your movies at Blockbuster. That's my family right there. We know what it was like, man. And we had the dirtiest beats in the world. We had the dirty beats, man. It sounded like they had fried chicken on it. It was real vinyl, man. And that shit was spinning and we was winning. You give me a keg party and we would roll up in a 5.0. Rag top down so my hair can blow. Girlies on standby, waving just to say hi. Did you stop? I drove by, man, in my 5.0. And we didn't dance like this shit in the 90s.
Today that I would bleed all over myself and light myself on fire. We got all ready to do it and they got this fucking show. Are introducing ICP. So this is more than a little honor. This is a big fucking honor. A really big fucking honor right now. And so, what I have right here is the most flammable fucking hairspray that you can get. It's level 5. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray it all over my head. Okay, like a good amount. And then I'm gonna fucking light my head on fire. And when I do that, I'm gonna want you guys to start making a good amount of noise to get ready to have the time of your lives. Gentlemen, are you ready?
Many people are now placing spiritual
consequence of man's abuse of nature. Fueling the speculation are reports from across the country that the only light piercing this churning, inky shroud are beams of sunlight, which are only falling on places of worship, all religions, and denominations. As the cloud continues to expand across the nation, the rest of the world looks on with growing concern.
Welcome to the Dark Carnival.
Swing our hatchets if we must!
We'll never die alone. Swing our hatchets if we must. You goddamn right, woo woo. Till we die.
Yeah, man, make sure you follow Humble Among on Instagram and on fucking YouTube. Remember that. Remember that shit. And hey, are you? Hey, come here.
Fuck you.
And there's a lot of beautiful juggalettes out here, too.
It sure is. It sure is.
Make sure you follow. Follow Humble Among. Right here. Right here.
So, man, how many gatherings have you been to?
Well, this is my second one so far.
Same, same.
I mean, hey.
$100 right up front.
I am getting love everywhere.
You sure are.
It is amazing. So, this is my second one here. I mean, for YouTube, it's awesome, man. It's just been great. I ain't never, had anybody just, come up and just hug me, you know? As I said in my yesterday's interview, and if you were, feeling in the clouds and whatnot, and you can't be yourself, this is the place to be yourself, man.
To really let loose and let your weirdo out.
Yeah. And see a bunch of titties.
Yeah, for real.
A bunch of titties. So, always, come for the titties. That. Come for the family love, man.
So on the topic of being a weirdo, what does being a juggalo mean to you? Like, either in a deep way or a not so deep way, like.
Well, in a not so deep way, you get to just have fun, act out, and just be who you are. And and then a second deep way is to be who you are. Is to actually know who you are as a person and not be afraid to show who you are as a person as well, man. And these people out here are people out here are just showing so much love, and you cannot imagine getting any kind of love anywhere else. Because due to the simple fact of the matter of going to regular shows and whatnot, and regular places and all that good stuff. And it's you can't just find nobody else who would just come up and say, come here, homie. This is what it's all about, homie. This is what it's all about. And it's there's a bunch of haters around here, but then again, we just kick those motherfuckers out the door because we ain't about that.
We don't give them energy.
I don't give them energy, man. I'm the energy god over here. I'm the energy god. Niggas try to steal that from me. Niggas try to drain my energy, man. Niggas try to steal that. You can't. I don't charge it because I always have it. I always have it, unlimited. I don't charge my energy. Never. And that's exactly what y'all should not do tonight. So if y'all come to party with me tonight, do not charge that shit. Have that shit. Do not just, don't be like, oh, I need to catch my breath. You better have that shit. Have that shit. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it's all about, being a juggalo, man. Just being who you are. And not being afraid of being who you are, and not being ashamed of that shit either, man. It's motherfuckers are always try to keep their heads in the clouds and try to be something that they're actually not. Try to cover up who they are as a person exactly, but not me, man.
Yeah.
I can't do it. Not me, because, like, I love being who I am. I love just, like, doing me. I can't, like, try to be, like, a copy of everybody else, you know? I mean, I pay homage to the Gathering. Without the Gathering, man, I wouldn't even, like, you know, I wouldn't even have this energy right now, man. Like, to, like, actually let loose. It's been amazing. Lovable, man. So, and you, man, you need to enjoy yourself, too. You
I will. With me. I'm having a fucking blast, bro.
Yes, sir. You're going to be partying with
What'd you
me,
think
man.
Of that bizarre shit last
oh,
night, bro?
Oh, man. I had to put my phone down, man.
Me too.
That's exactly what I needed to do. I needed to put my phone down, man, for all this partying. I don't even have my phone in my hand right now, as you can see.
I got a clip right at the beginning and then right at the end.
Like, yeah. The only time when you need to pull your phone out is to record some shit or take a picture. Right. Other than that, get off that shit.
Yeah.
Man, all that social media and all the other bullshit. Man, if anybody texting you, put that shit on hold and then let them put it on read, damn it. Like, just do what you do. And, this lady right here is amazing.
Thank you.
She's so amazing.
You guys are amazing. I appreciate Thank you guys. I'm Sarah, by the way.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi, what's your name?
Humble Among. I'm filming a documentary. Would you like to be in it?
Sure, why not?
Yeah, you're security here, huh? So you seem like you're very down with us, though, huh?
You know what? This is my first juggling.
Oh, okay.
So I'm super stoked. I love ICP. My daughter, she's also in love with ICP, so I'm old school, though, you know.
Yeah, I am, too.
But this has been great. I've been really appreciative to everybody in here. You guys have been so great.
That's awesome.
No problems from me so far, so it's good.
Yeah, that's
We've
great.
Had some issues, but nothing.
Yeah, it's mostly...
It happens.
It's stuff that's going to happen at any festival.
Absolutely.
It's the stuff that's going to happen at any festival.
You guys are amazing. Thank you so much. Do you have any more questions?
Do you consider yourself a juggalo or?
You know, maybe when I was younger.
Yeah.
Growing up now with all four of my babies, I gotta, you know. But I will say, when I get in them cleaning moods, I do pop on some.
That's what's
ICP,
up. Still go back to it.
Oh, yes. Yeah. My daughter, however, blares it from her room. She just jams it.
Did you get her into it?
Actually, my younger sister's a juggalo.
Oh,
she's a juggalette.
So did she kind of get her into it?
Oh, she did.
That's what's up.
Because I was like a little skeptical. I'm like, okay, this is like, I don't know if I want you like jamming to this. Yeah, you're still looking out. Because she started when she was like 15.
Yeah.
She got her into that super young. But
yeah.
She's like, Mom, I love it. I'm like, fuck it. Listen to it. I don't give a shit. That's what you like. Thank you.
Yeah, she like walked up to me and she was like, she's like, I'm security, but. I am totally in love with you.
I love it. He looks amazing.
Thank you.
He killed it in 2019, too. He got so much love in 2019.
Thank you.
And he's a gentleman, too. Look at him.
Thank you. Appreciate you guys so much.
I appreciate you.
You guys are super sweet. Thank you. If you guys need anything, let me know.
Definitely.
For sure.
Woo, woo. Have a great time.
Hey, we'll party with me.
Woo. She's fresh as shit.
Yeah, for sure. For sure, man. Like, come on, let's walk, let's talk.
Yeah, yeah.
Whatever,
let me
man.
Get
let's do that. Let's do that.
So we're here with this motherfucker right here who just walked up, and he said he saw me at the Hootenanny, and he also just said he went on the Bigfoot hunt. Was it last night?
Yes, last night. 3 a.m.
So, 3 a.m.?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
They get done till 6.
So, I have some questions with what exactly that was like. So, you guys went across, you guys met at the stage to coordinate, I assume?
Yeah.
That's what it looked like? So, and then you were going to go across the street and hunt for Bigfoot. Now, when I was camping one year at a KOA campground, they had a whole gimmick where they went on a Bigfoot hunt, right? So I was already familiar with this kind of a concept. So based off of that, I want to ask you a few questions. So were you in a hayride? Was it a hayride?
Yes, sir.
It was a hayride.
Oh, definitely a hayride.
Fucking A. Okay. Okay, so this is already confirming what I think that this was going to be. So in the hayride, was there a man in a Bigfoot costume that just kept running out and... showing
there was
up
like seven Bigfoot.
Really that
oh,
many
man, like seven or eight yeah it was wild
so That's funny as shit.
Man, they took a person's face off.
He took a person, so it was like gore effects and shit? Oh, fuck. So they went way harder with it than just what I saw at the KOA.
Oh, yeah.
Because they just had a whack-ass Bigfoot run across the road.
They had a bunch of TPs, kept stalling. You know, ICP, Violent J, and Shaggy, they were scared shitless.
Oh, man.
And all of a sudden, fucking Bigfoot ran out of nowhere, took this dude's face off. It was dope as shit.
That sounds amazing, actually.
Oh, it was dope.
Fuck. Now I kind of wish I would have done it.
He saved us, you know what I mean? Oh, yeah, he was at the end.
Did he wrestle Bigfoot?
He had a bunch of flares. He was throwing them motherfuckers at him. Oh, yeah. Shit.
That sounds amazing. I kind of wish I did it now.
Oh, it was great. I tell you what, best 350 ever. You know, fuck. I got to see Bigfoot for the first time.
I didn't know they were gonna do a whole like show with it. Damn it.
Oh, yeah, man. I was this close to ICP the whole time. You know, them talking. They had a guy doing a documentary about Bigfoot.
Oh shit.
Telling us everything about it. Oh yeah, man. We were scared shitless.
That sounds kind of fucking dope. Damn it. Well, I fuck with Bigfoot, so I'm like. But the 350 was the turnoff for me, and I'm regretting that now, I have to say.
Oh, definitely, man. Next time, I'll buy the 350.
Oh, you don't have to do that, my guy. I appreciate it, though. Let's see. I think I had another question. So how much time... So there was, like, a meet-and-greet type of thing included in this?
Yeah.
So did you get to sign stuff, or...?
Yeah, I got a big Bigfoot banner.
Oh, hell yeah.
I got it signed by both Shaggy 2-Goat Violent J. Yeah. I didn't get my picture because my phone was dead.
Oh.
I couldn't find my keys last night.
Oh, man. Yeah. In a certain mind state,
oh,
that'll do it.
Man,
that'll do it.
Yeah.
All right, man. So one more question. I've been asking this question of a lot of people. What does a juggalo... cut. What does a juggalo mean to you? Either, like, in a deep way or a not-so-deep way. What does being a juggalo mean to you? Hello.
Man, I've always felt alone, you know, going through life. I always felt different. And coming here to the gatherings, all the ICP events, I feel like I got people just like me.
Right.
So, you know.
I couldn't agree more, man. Like, I've got no juggalo motherfuckers in my life. Like, no juggalo friends. So it's like, I started doing this YouTube shit just because, like, I wanted to talk about this stuff and I got no one to talk to about it. So, like... And I'm starting to come out to these things more. Like, the Hootenanny was, like, the first one where I'm like, I'm just going to everything I can go to now.
Oh,
fuck this shit.
Oh, yeah.
So it's been really great, man. Like, I knew that this world was so magical, but it's just opening my eyes more and more. And, like, it's just amazing to me that so many of us who feel like outcasts can all come together and, like, it's okay. Like, that's the most amazing thing. Same. It's still
like
changing my life.
Me, you know?
It's still changing my life. That's the crazy thing.
Yeah.
All right, man. Well, it's great talking to you. Whoop, whoop. You have a good fucking gathering.
You too.
That's so fresh.
Can you get one with my daughter, babe?
Fresh as fuck.
That guy here was our guide.
I was
you tried.
Yeah. We had a couple people come through.
Steal one of our buddy's jerseys and some merch. Yeah. Our dude that runs the page bought
a page. Yeah. You bought mine. Ain't sweating it either. Just keep it. Bought one of mine.
Yeah.
That
was
mine.
Yeah.
No, no. Sweet.
Guy, let's go over here by the.
Oh, okay.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're good.
Does he have Atkins?
Yeah.
He got the burgers?
Yeah, I don't do shit with that. I just commentate, bro. That's dope, though. I fucking think it's sweet as fuck. Yeah. I'll tell him back then and I'll holler at you.
Can I get one quick?
Yeah, say what? Yeah, come on.
Shaggy, whoop whoop.
What up, though?
So what's up, brother?
Do me a favor and take my pick.
Can I get one real quick, bro?
Yeah.
There you go, bud.
Love you, bro.
I want to smoke you. Damn, man.
You're the shit for showing up here, Shaggy.
Oh, yeah, man.
So we're here with Crazy McCormick and the motherfucking Gathering. Shaggy Two Dope was just at TPE's camp, blowing minds and shit. So, yeah, man, how's your fucking Gathering going?
Gathering has been lit as fuck. Got hard in the paint last night from Kid and Play all the way to ICP.
Word up.
And beyond. Changed my clothes, came here, kicked it with my boys TPE, went to go see Misery, fucking came back. It's been a fucking experience and a half. Karma is on 17 levels.
Dude, for real. It's magical. It's magical out here.
It is.
What'd you think of that Bazaar set, man?
I lost my motherfucking shit throwing things and forgetting about what I just did. That's my shit, throwing stuff. Fucking, I love the shit out of doing that shit. The stage set was epic. The opening was great. I lost my shit to the John Carpenter sample.
That they got sued over.
I can't fucking explain in too many words how I felt about that shit. It was epic. It was karmic. I loved it.
Yeah, they killed it too. They killed it. They killed the shit.
Yeah.
Great.
I love the shit out of the entire fucking situation. Hanging out with all of my friends. I might have to name drop here, but Toxic Plague Entertainment,
what?
Child's Play Ninja, fucking Don Chaos, Carnival Spirits, all them fucking people, my people, loved every second of it.
So let's get into the question that I've been asking a lot of juggalos.
Right,
what does being a juggalo mean to you, either on like a shallow level or a deeper, more philosophical level?
I mean, the most common conception is just being an ICP fan. As you grow older in years, which, you know, I've been down for many years. But as you grow older in years, you start to realize that it's more than just a fan base. It is a collective of people who have felt the magic that ICP has put in through their music, and realizing, especially when you go to the Gathering, you realize that there are people out there just like you who have that same connection. To me, I think being a juggalo is being a part of that connection and sharing that with them. That's real.
That's what's up, man. Well, Crazy, it's fucking great to meet you. I hope you have a great rest of your gathering.
Oh, I'm gonna fucking get crazy. And you know I'm gonna get crazy.
And whoop, whoop,
whoop, whoop, motherfucker. And I'm out this bitch, bitch.
Thank you, bud.
One more time. Fuck the police. That's what the fuck I'm talking about. Y'all ready? Yeah, I got that adrenaline. Yeah, I got that adrenaline. Yeah, yeah, I got that adrenaline. I never stop moving because I got that adrenaline. Yeah, yeah, I got that adrenaline. Yeah, I got that adrenaline. Yeah, yeah, I got that adrenaline. I never stop moving because I got that adrenaline. Yo, bitch, fuck the pole pole, because I heard they looking for me. Catch me slipping, that's a no-no. Going ghost in my F-13s. Hey, you useless and you pissed, you ain't. Yeah. I do this, so slow, bitch, just wait and see. I keep it moving, I never run out of energy. Just know every move is part of my plan. It's all living my life. Darkness, following me for fast. Harvest, fighting the bodies of all kinds. It's time to make you motherfucking realize. Yeah. The team is coming. Come on. The team is coming. Yeah. Yeah. The team is coming. Detroit, Detroit, team, man. The team is coming. The team is coming. The team is coming. Detroit, team it. I speed it fast, but this time I'ma take it slow. D-Boy, one of the best, right off Plymouth Road. I can walk by a bitch, make her neck break. If we lock our shit, she might just faint. Now we're nigga mad, talking like he really bout it. I got a 2 and had a 7, so he better stop it. Citro, I'm the one that y'all been knocking. Been in the game for a minute, now I'm fighting shots. I know that there's some haters out there that are still whining, but I ain't worried about them because I got mine. Black Diamond, Long Island. The Detroit killers coming, everybody start a riot. Black Diamond, Long Island. Step into me sideways, you gon' get sodded. Black Diamond, Long Island. The Detroit killers coming, everybody start a riot. Black Diamond, Long Island. Step into me sideways, you gon' get sodded. I don't need no motherfucking guns. If y'all tuned in to the Gong Show, y'all know exactly what the fuck this is. Y'all ready? Let's go out with a bang, come on. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho. Walking a spot in the bass hit low. That's what I like. I think a nigga be mug when he hating for. Cause I just might pull out the 9 and a 44. Make it go night night. Don't think that I wouldn't do it, cause then I gotta go prove it to all these other motherfuckers that I am worthless. You little nigga don't wanna mess with a big dog. Anybody got a problem with me, I can fix y'all. Bloody everybody like I'm making a six ball. You wanna know by now that I get pissed off. Spray at a nigga, pop the drum, straight AK a nigga. The first you have been on mind of a killer, but there's a good part two that I had to deliver.
Yeah.
I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns.
Yeah.
I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns.
I'm a motherfucking psycho.
Pick it back up where I left off.
Left off.
I'm a ghetto boy. Yes, yes, y'all. Make a hit right till you lose it. And I can tear the club up with a mosh pit.
Yeah.
I'm a fight club instigator. Then I come in with heat.
Coming with heat.
Yeah, like the equator. I'm cooking the beat.
Yeah.
Talking shit to your boy. Come step to the plate.
Come step to the plate.
I was at the gathering.
You was at my head.
But you said you would be there. Were you hiding away?
Bitch.
This is your music so pretty, so bitch. I'll be sure you go to it. Like, you'll see my face. I don't need no gun. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho.
motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho. Beat a nigga ass. Everybody trying to stop me now. What? They know I'm about to kill him now. He's bloody and blue now. Hold on, let me catch my breath. What you looking at? You ain't never seen death. Now let me go back to finish your rest. By the time I'm done, ain't gonna be nothing left. What? A couple of teeth and it's hard in my hand. Okay. Still kicking till I get a good grip. Running niggas is a hobby, so you know how it gotta be. I run this shit, so go ahead and try to stop. Fuck you, little nigga, with your little subliminals. I'ma do something bigger that'll make you invisible. Down, nigga. Time before me. Do I need guns for you?
Go!
I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I don't need no guns. I'm a motherfucking psycho.
What up, though? Come see us at Merch Row, baby.
Thank y'all.
Woo, woo.
Much clown love, y'all. Family. Appreciate y'all.
Family. 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 Family.
Thank
fuck
y'all.
With y'all.
Thank y'all.
Thank you.
Give it up for DJ Clay. I personally apologize to all the photographers that I just fucked your shit up. Do not send me the bill. I do not. It's a lot of moshing and rioting. So if we can get something going in the center here, open up this pit a little bit, even if it's just some dancing or crazy shit. Because here I have a present for you guys. Hold on. I have a present for y'all.
Best I can do is
I'm going to throw this out there. Oh, his head's coming off. You already fucked him up. We got some pinatas and shit, and we're not throwing them out. Who like to party, and if people don't want to party with you, they're not my friends either, so fuck them. So, all right, I made it. I love you guys. All right, here's the thing. How many of you guys have had a bad roommate in your life?
Yeah, they like the way you dress and walk yourself, but bitch, they feelin' my bounce, they feelin' my bounce, bounce, bounce.
System. Did you blink when he did his thing? Then you missed him. Rebel King, handle the rings, you could kiss them. RP, the lady 16, if you miss him. There's a glitch in the system. If you blink when he did his thing, then you missed him. Rebel King, I handle the rings, you could kiss them. RP, the lady 16, if you missed him. Glitch, gay. Let's make that shit with Drake, bang. Glitch, gay. Make that shit, bang.
That was good, but I need that family love right now. Let's do it like this. Hey, yeah. Hey, family, yeah. Say hey, yeah. Hey, drop that motherfucker. Fuck out my fucking. Make some noise, hip hop. Life of the party.
All right, the rugged man.
The rugged man.
Put your hands in the sky, hip hop.
Let me hear you.
I've been sick, peace out, shit.
Walk up in the spot, make a body drop.
Say
psycho. Call the fucking cops, call the fucking cops. Somebody gonna become a dead body. I swear to God, I'm gonna murder somebody. I'm walking around with the neighborhood till I discover the house of a beautiful family. Walk up in the spot, make a body drop. Only daddy knows. Kids at school, I let mommy watch. I'ma need a cup of ice and some of that guava juice you got. I'm a vegan empanadas from another spot. Give me time, pop the microwave and hit these motherfuckers out. I'ma kill your neighbor's daughter now.
From, but I can tell you where you are now. You're fucking home. Welcome home, Juggalo!
Some more. Now look, you heard the boots and you heard the pants and you heard the Juggalo life,
But we got a new gathering anthem to add to the fucking repertoire this year. So I need you to do me a favor. Hold up, chump. Hold the fuck up. Open that middle up real nice and big. Let me get that middle bitch open the fuck up. And anybody who wants to let the moonlight shine on that fucking chocolate starfish, come put your fucking booty hole in this middle right here. I want to see how many buttholes we can get in one pit. The whole world watches Juggalos on this day, and we shall give them something to see. The greatest spectacle. I need everyone on this side to rush this side. I need everyone on this side to rush this side. Let's go! I need mayhem. Let's fucking go, Juggalo! Looking like a dirt bag. Creeping out the cut slow, baby, I'm an outcast. But I got the guts now. Don't wanna talk, but my soul won't shut up down. Judge all you wanna, do not give a fuck now. And we whoop whoop in this bitch. Whoop whoop. And the second thing is that I fucking love you. Every single fucking one of you. Even the ones who don't love me. You're still my fucking family. And I'll never forget that shit. You fucking hear me? Do you fucking hear me? Now let's take a family portrait. Put your motherfucking hands up. Josh, light these motherfuckers up, Josh. Get all the lights on my family. Light my diamonds up. That's what the fuck I'm talking about. Throw them motherfucking dubs up and put a C on it. Let's go. I love you. Hands up and scream. One more time. I will never forget this night so long as I fucking live. I love you so motherfucking much!
Rebel Flag?
Rebel fucking Flag? Who brought that?
Fuck that flag!
Who brought
that? I'm going to
Rebel Flag!
Fuck your Rebel Flag!
Every year they throw trash, the front and the back throw trash at each other.
How's it going? I'm famous.
Let's jump into
21. No fucking way.
He put it with Danny. He said put it right with the guy.
Yeah, I just said, I came with Danny.
Fucking live right now. Yo, what's up?
Okay.
No, you're here for 27.
I never think I
would.
Me neither. I'll be honest. Me neither.
I'm driving on the car.
Oh, yeah, you took the keys out. You guys want a picture or anything?
Yeah, I'm not even a picture.
I've never seen nothing like
like this, Rob. I'm the real, man.
When you eat your chicken with the hottest chocolate,
really shaking.
You fucking lay your ass. Because you're walking straight on fire right now.
Let me say this, though. You must. You must fucking score all three. Because that nigga's head you got. What?
All right, next card is... Six.
We're gonna give you a pass. Either one of our artists up here, we'll give you a pass. Just say you want a pass.
All right, the next card. What is that? What is the next card? It is a seven.
Seven. 17, 18.
You have two power chips left if you wish to.
17, 18. One power chip.
We need another power chip. Right. Here's the second power chip is gone. Which means you
but have to
hey,
the nipples
left.
Are covered.
And then you have to
look, 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 the nipples are covered.
Yeah, I don't think that's good,
though. How long did that take? We gotta have a time.
You didn't get that on camera, did you?
I can't see through the
titties is out everywhere.
The sun's super bright.
I'm doing a gathering documentary, actually.
Well, Jacob will cut it if he sees it.
Yeah, Jacob,
if you see anything in the background, just cut it.
I don't want to have a doggy. I'm not gonna take
just cut it and turn it back on.
19,
I'm not gonna have a doggy.
20.
Way too late.
I had to ask.
I'll
see you. I'll see you soon.
We got 20 right here.
What is this? They playing ball time?
Next card is a win!
I'm
gonna
be touching my titties.
Might be. I might be. Little B roll for you.
TPC. TPE real small.
Hell yeah.
Yo. Yo.
Rare to pull off than anybody wants.
You can go ahead and leave one on extra for Humble because he likes it.
Yeah, well he likes this fucking burnt as fuck.
Humble likes fucking shoe leather.
I got you, big dog.
That's what somebody who drives a Prius likes.
That one in the middle over there at the end. It can be that one. Yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely mine. That boy's definitely mine. I was going to call that one anyway, so thank you.
Really?
For real.
Same guy.
Same guy. Stoney, how you feeling, bud?
Good, bro.
You want to do an interview?
Yeah, we can do it.
Fuck yeah.
A little fucking dehydrated, but we can do it.
So you're feeling... He was feeling a little out of it after being in the pit for... But Free Will?
Yeah, Free Will. Yeah, we got turned up, bro.
Yeah.
They shot us.
I got to see a lit Stoney, if you will.
Yeah, I get turned up sometimes.
So now that you're feeling better, we're gonna do our interview with Stoney fucking Low. Thank you for your support, by the way, and for being such a fan of what I do as a humble among an artiste, you know what I mean?
Right on, dude. I love your fucking music.
Thank you very much, sir. But this is about you, Stoney fucking Low. So, this TB. Is your first gathering of the Juggalos.
Yes.
How's your experience going so far?
It's the last day, I should remind people. It's very surreal. I've been to clown shows before. Like, my first two clown shows were American Psycho Tour, and then I seen the Old Shit Tour. And I will say that outside ICP is a whole different ball game, you know? Like, they bring so much more of a stage presence outdoors, I think. But there's so much fucking love here. Like...
Look at all this shit.
Like, do you see anybody fighting? Do you see anybody screaming at each other? It's all love out here. It's all love. Like, where else are you going to find it?
Yeah, where's Caesar's a season?
I'm saying garlic. Not worry about. government or politics or fucking COVID. This is a time for us to chill. We're family. It's amazing. I made excuses for like 21 years before I came here, you know what I mean?
That shit gets fucking close. It's great you're fucking here, bro. What's that?
So that shit gets close to my face.
Sorry, bro. I'm trying to get cool shots, you know what I mean? But, so, the deep philosophical question that I've been asking a lot of folks, you don't have to get deep with it. You can get shallow with it if you want. But what does it mean to be a juggalo to you, Stony Low?
I mean, this is somebody who just don't give a fuck, honestly. You know, like, we've been judged for the way we fucking dress and look all of our fucking life, you know what I'm saying? And in this environment, like, you ain't got to fucking worry about that. Like, this place gives me the confidence to go out in the real world and say, you know what, fuck you if you don't like me. You know what I'm saying? I'm juggalo for life. Just like what Violent J said about the butterfly in 17, you know what I mean? Like, it's fucking love, and you got to preserve the good shit. I think that's what being a juggalo is trying to preserve that good that's still left in the world. Remembering to stay away from this fucking ass evil shit.
Word,
that's
man.
What being a juggalo is to me. Somebody that can be an individual and not have to worry about fucking judgment. You can be your own motherfucking ninja if you want to. Or you can be a fucking muddalo. Or you can be a fucking tweakalo. Or whatever the fuck you want to be in this bitch. No one's going to fucking judge you for it. That's what I think being a juggalo for me.
Fucking A. Hell yeah, Stony. Well, is there anything you would like to say about your experience at the gathering this year or being a juggalo in general or anything like that?
Man, honestly, when it comes down to it, like, I wouldn't have any of this shit if it wasn't for Toxic Plague Entertainment. Like,
shouts out to fucking TPE.
Yeah, no shit. Like, Plague does so much for juggalos, like, it's fucking wild.
Yeah.
And, like, he's got so much fucking love.
And it's been awesome chilling with you guys, by the way.
Yeah,
thank you for having me.
100%.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you for having me, dude. It's an honor. For me, this was finding myself again. You know, like, I'm clean from hard drug usage for, like, 4 years come September 16th. And part of this was, you know, pretty having to myself to get back on track. You know? We're going to be here again next year, bro.
Yeah. The Gathering of Dreams?
Yes.
The Gathering of Dreams.
Bro, I will say that shit about Violent J, bro, my God.
Yeah, let's talk about that, actually, real quick.
I wasn't at the seminar. It was honestly too fucking hot for me, so we had some people kind of report back to us. But from what I understand, like, Violent J's got, like, an AFib or something like that? Or something.
Well, first of all, I guess he said he has insomnia.
Right.
That's how he started it off to explain last night's Inner City Posse shit.
Is that
shit.
Why they didn't play?
He said he was up three nights, no sleep.
Oh, no shit.
And so then he explained the AFib thing. He went, he wasn't feeling right. He said he couldn't even walk to his mailbox without getting winded. Walk, he can't, his studio is like 40 feet from his house. He said he couldn't walk to the studio without getting winded. So it, jump steady brought him to the hospital. He was in the hospital for a few days. They CAT scanned him, ultrasound him. And that was when I got nervous because I'm like, oh fuck, it's gonna be cancer or something. But it's, yeah, it's AFib. And he said he had heart failure.
Oh,
actually,
shit.
And not, the doctor said he has an AFib, and
well, I guess you gotta take that shit super serious if you wanna keep going, man.
Yeah, well, the way I'm looking at it, and I think the best thing you can do is take the positive here, is this means Violent J can, and Violent J said this, they can make more music.
Oh yeah.
They'll be touring less, so they can make more music. So that's a good thing.
That means we'll get the rest of the
And then
card making,
we're not so. Gonna get shows aren't going away. A lot of motherfuckers are acting like shows are going away. They're not going away.
So
they're
do
just
you
gonna
think
be
they're
less.
Gonna keep gathering? I mean,
I hope
be,
so.
Dude,
I hope
honestly,
so, man.
It would be kind of like an unwise decision if you didn't continue.
I would hope so.
Dude,
they basically announced one more for next year, so we know we're getting another one.
Wicked Clowns Never Die. This Dark Carnival shits. Like, okay, I will say another thing about my first time at the gathering is, like, you go to indoor shows with the clowns and, like, everybody you know is loud and shit, but here you can walk to the edge of the fucking the goddamn crowd that's over here and dude, you look back, nobody's missing any single word. Like, that crowd side doubled immediately as soon as they took stage. Like, I've never been around that many people.
I wonder if it gets that crazy tonight. Probably
that
crazier, right?
After the fucking news that Jay dropped, I think everybody's going to really fucking get it good.
Grab binds are over there.
I mean, honestly, realistically, like, who knows how long this is going to last.
Yeah.
At least with ICP.
Figure it out.
I mean, Ouija's the fucking, honestly, I think the next.
I just could.
Especially after last night.
I mean, dude, they're smart.
It's a pretty fucking legendary night last night.
They're smart people outside of being businessmen, and I think that, you know, Ouija having the fucking main set for Friday. I think that really helped because, like, it showed that he could handle having a mainline act at, you know, one of these events, and he fucking killed it.
Right, definitely.
I've never seen a pit so fucking live, dude.
Yeah. And I was so happy Jay performed the way he did, you know what I mean? He murdered his set. Murdered it.
Hell yeah.
What is that?
Oh shit.
These motherfuckers are hard, dude. Free will.
This is what almost cost Tony
my life.
A heat stroke.
I started to pin this bitch and it almost cost me my goddamn life.
But he went crazy.
They shouted TPE out on main stage. That was fresh.
I kind of wish I had my shit out for that, man. I kind of fucked that up. I should have had my shit out for that. I could have definitely caught that.
Yeah,
oh, well.
Pretty dope, man.
You can't catch everything at the Gathering of the Juggalos, folks. You can only do your best.
Yep. Say, drink water. That was my
definitely drink water.
If I was to learn a lesson on all this shit, drink motherfucking water.
Yeah. Yo, I got sunburnt like a motherfucker today anyway.
I got a little bit.
All right, Stoney.
It was good talking to you.
Thank you fucking for talking to me, man. Whoop whoop, homie.
Whoop, whoop.
I should be filming this. What the fuck am I doing?
he was talking about your shit too. Free will down there.
Oh, word?
They were talking about, because they said that dude with the green hair. I was like, that's a homie Humble. And straight up, I was like, he's doing his shit too. So.
Oh, that's fresh, dude. Thank you.
Because they already knew who you were. I didn't even have to shout you the fuck out.
What the fuck?
So they obviously watch your shit. So.
This goddamn name of mine is getting around.
Well, you're doing something right, obviously.
Yeah, that's fucking fresh, dude.
Straight the fuck up.
But yeah, man, this is
I think cool.
What's up, man?
What's up, Blase? How you doing?
Good, how are you? Out there to sleep. I've been drinking too much Kool-Aid. Drop that shit. If you don't feel like you're the realest juggalo in the world, make some fucking noise. If you feel like you're the realest juggalo at the gathering, make some fucking noise. Adjust the game. Plus, I came to bust your brain. Was city up in flames.
Detroit.
Detroit, we all insane. Every block is all the same. I'm with the mob and
stay away.
My niggas were already
chill with the pain.
Instead of my
call me the game.
Just hold these down the ride.
Ooh.
They always right outside.
Where?
Waiting for infiltration, but patient with information. Ready to make a statement
with no fucking hesitation.
Universal, but I'm still
one of a kind.
Spent my mind coming up on my grind. Hey. With my heart was left with a shine. I gave my style a
tweet
for niggas who thought I'd be. For haters who ever had
doubt.
The boy was never a pilot. Intimidating in their syllables.
I'm the one that they call in my genitals.
I'm a general mixed with a criminal.
When the streets and I came up for nothing.
No, I'm preaching the pain in the south.
Oh,
I came on the bottom three tracks. Dumb by psychopathic, save my life and help my
rules. Rules,
cowboy is.
I'm gonna dance my ass. I'm gonna pop the perch like
is crack. I ain't copy, sell it up, nigga.
She used to be thick, had sex with a crack. And now she's sick. She offered you some help. If you're down, find some drugs. Just make sure you're gonna
eat. You better wear a glove.
I'm sick of body figures with 18-year-old stuff. Ain't doing no more. Take the next step.
Zero, 9. motherfucker got to lie for. I'm not blowing out now. Motherfucker late. But I got me a mate. Dabbing and crusty gate.
Suckers, and furthermore, I think you better check your mints.
Come on, let's
cut this place. You better get the fuck out of here and take your bitches with you, especially Ugg Mug here.
What's he doing?
Yeah, yeah, come on.
Thank you. Check it out, man. ICP back in the house, man. Funny J, man. Too dope, man.
I like it when we play in the dark. Let's have some fun in the dark.
Yeah.
go. Y'all know this shit. Y'all can fuck with it.
Yeah.
you, Juggalo!